On now? I'm gonna need some, yeah, but we're streaming to the world, so we have to. Oh, is that, okay. Great. Now you can hear me.
Oh, yeah.
So in our new world, I have to speak slowly so you can understand me with a mask, looking like a duck-billed platypus. So we want to tell you that we're so thrilled to be here live tonight and have all of you with us. And we want to tell the audience that's watching us from afar that ordinarily those of you who have not been in this beautiful room, we have a much lower light, more dramatic lighting, but tonight, in order for you to see us from afar, we have all the lights on. And if you have never been in this room before, we hope you'll join us sometime in real life. And these lucky people are here to hear what I consider the greatest flutist in the world. And people know I have very high standards. I think Robert has gold that comes out of his mouth. So we're just very, very happy to have Robert Langevin, principal flute of the New York Philharmonic, and Min-Young Kang, his pianist tonight. Program. As you will see, the first two pieces on the program were originally written for violin and piano, and this is not uncommon. Musicians are happy to have more than one instrument playing for economic and other reasons. So the Mozart Sonata for piano and violin in B-flat and the Schumann Sonata for violin, piano, and A minor are tonight being played by this great flute player. So without further ado, we will invite them to join us and fill your ears with joy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. We're just going to take 5 minutes, so if you want to stretch your legs, we'll be back soon. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Whereas I thought that the first two composers didn't need any introduction, I think it might be useful to say a few words about the next two composers who might not be as well known to the general public. This next composer, by the way, if you wonder why we took a little break, you can see. When we were rehearsing the other day, Min Young said to me, "I have two dresses and I cannot decide which one to wear." So I said, "Wear them both." So the next composer, and I thought I should go along with it, so I just changed. The next composer, Philippe Gaubert, is well known to flute players because he was a flutist himself. He was considered the greatest French flutist of the first half of the 20th century. But not only was he a great flutist, he had a quadruple career. He was a flute soloist. He also became flute professor at the Paris Conservatory, replacing his teacher, Paul Tafanel, and he formed a lot of great flutists. But every day he would wake up at 4 in the morning and from 4 to 7 a.m. would reserve the time to compose music. So he's composed a fair amount. Unfortunately, most people don't know his music nowadays except flute players, but he's written quite a lot. And you'll see that this piece we're playing was written in 1917 while Debussy was still alive, and you'll recognize the influence of Debussy. What's interesting also about Gaubert is that he performed with Maurice Ravel, with whom he was a direct, contemporary. I mean, Ravel was born 4 years before Gaubert and died 4 years before, so they were really exact. And of course, he knew Fauré and Saint-Saëns and all these other composers. And at some point he not stopped but played a lot less because he got into conducting, to the point that he became music director of the Paris Opera. So he was a very busy man. And I was just reading that at the age of 16 he was appointed solo flutist of the Paris Opera, just to show how great he was. So this piece, and also I learned that the last time he performed in public, he played this sonata. I mean, he's written three sonatas, he's written other pieces for flute, but this must have been one of his favorite since he chose to perform that for his last appearance. Thank you.
So this
final composer in the program, Paul Schoenfeld, is an American composer. He was born in Detroit in 1947, and he's professor of composition at the University of Michigan. The music I know of his, I've always found interesting. He seems to use ethnic dances in his music. I mean, he's written a number of klezmer-inspired pieces. This one is not klezmer, but I feel that it was probably inspired by his travels. It's music of the Americas. It has four dances. The first one is a samba. The second one is a tango. The third one is Tin Pan Alley. And the last one is square dance. Thank you.
Thank you.